Hello everyone. So in today's class we are going to discuss about the following topics. Let's start with first of all osmosis experiment. So here what is osmosis? Movement of water molecule from higher concentration to lower concentration through a semi-permeable membrane. So this we have already discussed yesterday also. So I'm repeating this. Here you can see in this setup semi-permeable membrane is used. And then we have example of beaker. So we have partitioned the beaker with the help of semi-permeable membrane and two different type of solutions have been taken here. So osmosis is taking place between them. So in osmosis experiment, following materials are required. So we need peeled potato, knife, 20% sugar solution, petri dish, distilled water and few pins. So let's take the potato and then we have to cut the sides of the potato so that it can be placed inside the petri dish. It can easily settle down there. After this we need to make a pit inside the potato, like cavity, cup-like structure, so that sugar solution can be kept inside it easily. So let's place that potato in the petri dish and take distilled water and now fill the cavity of potato with 20% sugar solution. And now we have to just enter a pin at the level of sugar solution. Keep this setup for 3 hours untouched. And after 3 hours, you're going to check the level of sugar solution inside the pit. And whatever changes are there, now we have to introduce new pin at the level of solution. Okay. So this shows that osmosis has taken place because in the petri dish you have taken water and inside that potato we have taken sugar solution. So and the potato cells, those are having semi-permeable membrane. Now what is the conclusion of this experiment? You can see here on the screen, you can see the water from the petri dish, it rises in the pit of the potato and by this osmosis is taking place. The water is actually moving through the plant cells of potato. All right. So what precautions we have to keep in mind during this experiment? The cavity should be wide so that the layer of potato should be very thin. Water can easily cross that layer, otherwise it is going to take long time. Now we will start with, so here in this experiment, so this is experiment setup. You can see here beaker of water is here, thistle funnel with sugar solution, and it is attached to a clamp on a stand, right? So here on the mouth of thistle funnel, cellophane paper is binded. Cellophane paper is biodegradable substance, so it will act as semi-permeable membrane. So you can observe here, water, sugar solution separated by membrane. So here osmosis will take place. Now water molecule from beaker will enter into thistle funnel with the help of this cellophane paper. And the level of sugar solution will rise after 2 hours. So first we have to note down the initial level and after 2 hours we will note down the final level. So this shows that osmosis has taken place, right? For this we have to read the whole page. All the things are given in detail. So let's see here. Here we have to take control also. So in 9th class we have read about control setup. So in the same experiment, if we want to have control setup, so we are going to change the cellophane paper. We will change this membrane. So this was semi-permeable. Now we will have impermeable membrane. We will take some rubber sheet or plastic sheet through which no molecule will enter into the thistle funnel. So there will be no osmosis. So control setup is such setup in which all the experimental setup, only the main thing under study is going to be missed. So here in osmosis, semi-permeable membrane is necessary. So we are missing it. then it will be our control setup, right? When we taste this water after 2-3 hours, it is not going to taste sweet. Why? Because sugar is not moving outside. Okay? Water molecules are moving inside this thistle funnel. So in the same experiment, if we apply weight on the thistle funnel, so due to the weight, there will be no entry of molecule, as when the water molecule enter, the level of the solution will rise up, and due to weightage, the level will not rise. It will remain at the same place. So that means water molecules are not moving inside. No movement is there. So this weight or this pressure is equal to that pressure due to which there will be no osmosis. So such pressure is known as osmotic pressure. So minimum pressure which is required to nullify, or you can say stop, osmosis is called osmotic pressure. Here definitions are given, so you have to read these very carefully. After this we have the next topic, tonicity. So relative concentration of the solution that determine the direction and extent of diffusion is called tonicity. So here we are actually comparing the concentration of two different solution. So on the basis of this, we have total three type of solution: isotonic solution, hypotonic solution and hypertonic solution. First of all, we have isotonic solution. Here we are going to compare the concentration of our solution with the cell sap of the plant cell. Cell sap means the solution present inside the cell is called cell sap. So if the concentration of our solution and cell sap will be equal, will be same, then our solution will be known as isotonic solution. So when we are keeping plant cell in isotonic solution, there will be no osmosis because on both side water molecule will be same. Second, we have hypotonic solution. So in this solution, this solution is actually less concentrated, less dense solution than the cell sap. That means this solution contains more water molecule. So when we are keeping plant cell in hypotonic solution, because of less concentration, water molecule will move from this solution into the cell. So endosmosis is taking place here. Then we have hypertonic solution. Hyper means more, higher. Okay, so in this condition, the solution's concentration will be more than the cell sap. That means solution will be thicker than the cell sap. So what is going to happen? Now cell sap is having more water molecules than this solution. So water molecule will move from cell to the outside. So here we have exosmosis, right? So here you can see on page number 43, figure 4.8 is given. Both animal and plant cells are taken. So they are kept in isotonic solution. So there will be no change in the cell. They will remain as it is. So if we are putting these cells in hypertonic solution, means concentrated solution. For example, if you take 50% sugar solution, if you take 20 or 30% salt solution, those will be quite concentrated, quite dense. Right? If we are keeping such cell in hypertonic solution, what is going to happen? Cell will release water. That means exosmosis will take place and cell will shrink. And shrunken stage is always known as flaccidity, flaccid cells. Okay? Third condition we have, we can keep these cells in hypotonic solution. Hypo means having less concentration than the cell sap. Hypotonic solution is always having more water molecule. So water molecule will move into the cell and osmosis will take place. Right? Cell will get swollen, or you can say turgid. And phenomena is turgidity. Here you can see RBC, it burst due to endosmosis. And here in plant cell you can see it is fully swollen just because of cell wall. It is safe. Otherwise it can also burst. So let's take an example of experiment here. In this experiment, the tonicity is discussed. So you can see the definitions of isotonic, hypotonic and hypertonic solutions, right? So all these solutions will be used here in this experiment. So we are taking the epidermis of onion cell, right? So here we are going to use onion, distilled water, ग्लिसरीन, शुगर सॉल्यूशन, नीडल्स, ड्रॉपर एंड माइक्रोस्कोप एंड ऑल्सो फिल्टर पेपर. सो एपिडर्मिस विल बी सेपरेटेड फ्रॉम द अनियन सेल. देन वी हैव टू कीप द एपिडर्मिस ऑन द ग्लास स्लाइड. With the help of a drop of glycerin, we have to fix the epidermis on the glass slide. Then it will be covered by cover slip without having any bubble, right? Then we will adjust this slide under the microscope and then it will be viewed. So you can see here under the microscope, so such cells will be visible. So these are at normal state. These are in normal condition. So now we will put sugar solution drop and that solution will enter into the epidermis. With the help of filter paper, that sugar solution can be moved inside the epidermis with the capillary action, right? Now sugar solution is hypertonic in nature, and due to this plant cells, these epidermal cells, they are now becoming flaccid. They are shrinking now, right? Because of exosmosis, water molecule from the plant cell will move outside, making the cell flaccid. Now we are putting distilled water here. After this step, now cell will regain their shape because water enter into the cell because of endosmosis, and cell regain their normal state. So in this experiment, I have discussed the tonicity of solutions. Now see the example of Spirogyra. This is algae. So when we have put hypertonic solution, they shrink. So this was today's topic, right? In next topic, we are going to cover plasmolysis and deplasmolysis tomorrow. Thank you, students.